Assalamu alaikum everyone, welcome back to Restaurant Management System Tutorials. Today is our lecture number 15 and in today's class we are going to discuss the orders window with respect to other roles, right? We have seen in the previous lectures the orders window with respect to the admin, so that the admin can take the order or place the order when it is necessary for him or her. Now what happens after we place the order? Okay, once the admin places the order, it is by default in the pending mode as we have discussed in the previous lecture. And now when you place the order should be highlighted in the kitchen to the chef, and the chef then start preparing the meal and the order with respect to the priority of that order and the time of that order. Okay, so that's what we are trying to do in today's class, and we'll see further more things also that come in between. So let's start and have a look what we have today. All right, first of all I must mention one thing that I have done already for you people, is that when I place an order, let's say I wanted to place a Pepsi in a dine-in mode on table floor 1 and table 1. Look, the table 1 is not selecting. What is this? This is the quality of the software, that if the order is already exists on this table, on this particular table, then on that particular table no other order can be placed until and unless the order is finished or not. Right, so look, when I select table number 2, look, it is selected, but when I select table number 1, it is not selecting, because you already have that order that you have placed in the previous lecture. So how I did that, let me show you. Let's go to the orders window first and go to the tables drop down list. Double click on your tables drop down list, and look, I have created a method here with the name check table status. Let us go to this method and see what's the code in between. Okay, so that's my method, and it is returning a boolean, and inside this method I have asked for table ID and floor ID, and then I have created a stored procedure with the name check table busy and free. So let's go to that procedure, check table busy and free, inside our database programmability stored procedures, and then we have check table status. So check table and right click and modify it. So look what I have done, I have just selected the order ID with respect to the floors and the tables that we have picked up when we are placing the order. Okay, so what I have done here, I have passed the floor ID on runtime and I have passed the table ID on runtime. Based on that floor ID and table ID, the order ID will be picked up or will not be picked up. If the order is there in this mode, in which mode? The status is 0. That means the order is in pending mode or the order is in served mode. Okay, so whenever you have an order in pending mode, 0 means pending mode and 1 means the served mode, so only that order ID will be picked up. So if their ID exists, that means the table is busy, and if there is no data, that means there is no active order on that particular table. So that's the stored procedure that I have called here and passed these parameters, floor ID and table ID, and if the data exists, then return true or make it false, and then in the end I have returned that stat variable. Simple. Okay, so that's the code, that's this function check table status, and inside this function, after this function I have called this function on table selected and exchange. When my table is not empty, table drop down, so take the table ID and take the floor ID from the floor drop down, and if the table exists, if the order exists on that table, then what you are doing, you are making that selection again empty. You cannot able to select that, and you can pass a message box here also that the order is already there or the table is occupied. You can write a message here also. Okay, so that's what I have done already for you people. Now I hope it is clear to everyone that why the floor 1 and table 1 is not coming, because the order is already there. Okay, now in today's lecture what we have to do, we have to go to another domain with respect to the kitchen and with respect to the kitchen area. When you place an order from here, the order will go to the kitchen area, and then after completing the order, the people or the person who is operating the software from the kitchen side will update the status of the order from pending to serve. Okay, and let me tell you one more thing. This is the admin side. Okay, so when some other role, let's say the chef or some other role will log into the system, this screen should not come. In fact, another screen come that will show the orders that are coming. That's it. Okay, and some other features if you wish to add. So let us create another dashboard or home screen for the kitchen area, and then we'll create the respective windows for that. So right click, add Windows form, and give it a name, home screen 2, because I already have the home screen, so I'm giving it a name, home screen 2. Right click, view code, and to inheritance from sample. I'm not using sample 2 because I'm going to create another home screen for the kitchen area, kitchen part. Okay, so that's my home screen, and give it a title, home screen, it's fine. Then increase its size, or no problem, because the window is maximized when it will run. Now pick up table layout panel from the containers, table layout panel, make it doc fill, and add rows and columns. Okay, and I have applied some rows and columns. Now make them equally distributed across the screen. Okay, these are my columns, and then go to your rows and make them also 50-50%. Now that's fine. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to create a screen for a button here. So let's copy the button from the home screen. So open your home screen. Where is your home screen default? That's the admin home screen. Okay, so pick up the orders button, copy it, and go to your home screen too and paste it here. Okay, orders. So when the person or the personnel from the kitchen area open the software, this screen should display. So for that purpose, what you have to do, you have to go to your login window. So let's go to login screen and double click on your login button. Look what is happening here. If retrieval dot is valid user, then open this screen, admin screen. Okay, now if I go to this particular function that we have created in the previous lectures, right click, go to definition. Look what I have done here. In this function I have picked up the role also. That's why that's the reason I have retrieved the role also here. So you are retrieving the role of the user when you are logging in and storing it in a property of string data type. So I will use this property here. So if after logging in, if retrieval dot role is equals to what is the role, let's say you have to specify here chef. Okay, the role is, if the role is chef, then what you have to do, you have to open some other window, else. Okay, let me write here, else if retrieval dot role is equals to, okay, let me write here chef, and then write here admin. If I'm not wrong, that this is the spelling. So else if chef, then come inside. So if we are in role, so cut it and paste it here, admin, and then for the other window, that is home screen 2, so right here home screen 2, and copy it and paste it. Okay, now let's start and check after login what will happen. Right now we haven't entered any role with respect to chef, so let's log in with admin first. Okay, look, it is not login because we don't have the role with the name that I have specified. So let me check what are the names in the roles table we have. So edit, Okay, it's the complete name, administrator, and then the manager, and then the waiter. Okay, so I have these three roles. So let me copy this role name and paste it inside the code. So if you have administrator role, then come to this screen. Now it's fine. I don't have chef, so I'll add chef, no problem. Look, I'm on my admin screen. Now let's go to the roles window and click view and click add, and let us add a new role, that is chef. Okay, and click add. Chef added successfully into the system. Now let us log out, and then do we have an employee that belongs to the chef role? No, we don't have any employee that belongs to the chef role. So first we have to add employee also, that is a chef. So let me add here, let's say Hamad, phone number is any, and the address is any, and then the role is chef. Okay, it is coming from database. What is the user of this particular? So you are admin and you are creating a user and his password. So his password is 12345. Okay, so let's save it. Hamad added successfully into the system and he is a chef. Okay, now let's log out and log in from Hamad. So when we write the name Hamad and password is 12345, login, look. So when you run your software on the network, when Hamad will log in, this screen will display it, and when admin will log in, that screen will be displayed. So that's what security is. You can implement role-based security. Okay, now when Hamad will open the software and when he click on this role button, what will happen? A screen should appear and all the orders that are placed should display in a highest priority wise, the order in the orders that come first. We have to implement the first in first out scenario here. That means that order that come in first should be treated first, or should be tackled first, or should be served first. So let's create a window on which our already coming orders should be displayed. So let's create it. Go to your software, right click, add, and a window, Windows form, and right here chef order window. Okay, add it, right click, and go to its code, and what you have to specify here, sample 2. Okay, on this window now you'll receive everything here. In the grid view you have to display the order. So how can you display that particular order? All right, so on this window, guys, on this white area on the right hand side, we will display all the orders that are there, that are in pending mode, and when you click on that order, the details of that order will display here. Okay, so let's do that. Okay, to achieve this, we have to go first on our database and we have to fetch the orders that are in pending mode. So what I should write here, I should write the details, let's say create procedure. We have to create a new procedure, st underscore get pending orders. Okay, or get orders, if you specify here get orders only, and then you have to specify a select query, select all from orders. First of all I will use this scenario. Okay, and let's execute this query. What will happen? Okay, so these details are appearing here, but I don't need this detail because you are in kitchen mode. So in kitchen mode, what you need the order and its details, that's it. Okay, and you, and what specific details you need here, the date and the customer ID, but because the kitchen does not really take care of the customer ID, it's not necessary for the kitchen people to deal with the customer ID. And then the order type, yes, the order type should be displayed here, and then the floor and the table ID should be there, and amount should not be there. Okay, we only need to display the order ID. So what is the order ID? O dot order ID as order ID, and then you have to specify the order status, order dot status. So in case of this status, we have to mention your case when. So case when status is equals to 0, then specify that you are in pending mode. So right here, pending, because these zeros and ones are for our development side, and but the user will display, will see these things. Okay, so when we have zero, then pending, else case when o dot status is equals to one, then it should be displayed served, and else case when o dot status o dot o underscore okay, what's the mistake, else case when, there is no mistake, just copy this code and paste it here. Okay, case when status is 2, so then what you have to display, complete or finished, whatever you can specify right here, completed. Okay, that's it. And then because you have started three cases, so you have to end it three times. The first case is end now, then the second case, and then the third case, and then as the status heading. That's it. So let me make it a little bit downwards so that you can understand it clearly. Now I hope it is clear to everyone. This is what the mistake. Okay, so if zero, pending, if status is one, then served, and then the status, if the status is two, then it is completed. I hope it is clear to everyone. But this was not as such required, because the kitchen people will only see the pending orders. Okay, the kitchen people will only see the pending orders, that's it. So now let's select and check what is the result. So one is, there is one order and its status is pending. Okay, now you have to specify further more details, that let's say order dot, sorry, from on this side. Okay, o dot, what else you should display, the status and the time, if you wish to take the time. Yes, we can do that also. To take the order, we can specify the time also, so that the order will come with respect to time, in ascending order or in descending order. You can do that, but right now I'm not changing that things, but you can change with respect to time also. So what else we should display here, the table ID and the floor ID, is it it should come here or not? All right, so that's the case. We'll only display these details, but in which order, in ascending order. So order by o dot id asc, that means the order that come first will display first. Okay, ascending order. So let's execute this query and let me show you first. Okay, so that's the result, order id and then status. So execute this query, commands completed successfully. Now what will happen, in next, create procedure st underscore get order details, and here you have to specify, select what, from order details od, where od dot order id is equals to 1, because when you select this, the id is 1. Okay, so when the chef click on this order, you will pick up that id and then select all the details from the order details table. So let's execute this. So these things are appearing here. Okay, but now the data that is displaying here is not so much apparently understandable to the chef, because the chef don't know what is the product id for and all that. So we have to apply join here with the product tables, so that the product name will also come. So let's go to the end here. Okay, od inner join products, inner join from details od. Okay, inner join, what we have, products, no, menu. So inner join menu m on m dot id is equals to od dot pro id. Okay, now what you have to specify here, m dot name as the name of the product, is the item, or right here item, okay, item, and then specify od dot what else we have to specify here. Alright guys, so one thing that we have done a huge mistake in the previous lectures is that we haven't added the quantity inside the orders detail. So we have to add another column with the name quantity here in orders detail table. So OD underscore QUAN, how much required, how much that product is required, we have to specify that also. So what you have to take here, that's the quantity, so tiny integer, and then right now save it as null because you already have data inside order details, okay, so that's why I have entered as null. Now let's go to the order details insert procedure, order details insert procedure, and here you have to specify at the rate QUAN quantity, that is tiny integer, and here you also have to specify at the rate quantity, that's it. So that's the changes I have done. Now let's go to the orders window first and resolve this error. Orders window, okay, and in orders window what we have to specify on the save button, let's go to the code of the save button, where we have the save button, okay, insert order details, right click and go to definition, here we have, and insert order details, let's go to its definition, and in this procedure I have to add a parameter, that is the quantity, so QUAN, I will add it in the parameters at the rate QUAN. Let me zoom in so that you can be able to see it more clearly. QUAN is the parameter, QUAN, and here you have to specify integer 16 QUAN, that's it. So you have passed your quantities also, so from where you can pick up that quantities, let's go to the orders window. Look, because you are in the grid view and you have specified the quantity in the grid view, okay, so can I write here comma convert dot to integer 16, and then you have to specify quantity GV, sorry, raw dot cells of quantity GV, put in inside double quotes, and then specify dot value dot to string, that's it. So you have passed now the quantity with respect to your order, okay, so save it, and that's it. So now because our data is now get wrong, so I have to truncate the tables, let's say truncate table orders, execute, okay, because that's a foreign key table, so you have to use some other method to truncate the table, let me write that. Alright guys, so that's the code to truncate the orders table. When you delete, or when you delete everything from the orders table, the orders detail table should automatically cleared. Let me show you. Let's go to the order details table, close it and right click and edit. Look, because of the foreign key relationship. Now let's add an order inside the software. Okay, so login and orders, let me place the first order, let's say chicken steak, and the quantity is 2, order type is dine in, floor is 1 and table is 1, and then add to cart, and one more thing I have to specify here, biryani, and the quantity is 1 and add to cart, so that's my total amount. So is it correct or not? Yes, it is correct, because chicken steak is 450 and I am getting 2. So 450 into 450, 900, and then 1050 is the amount. It's correct. And then click save. So order placed. After the order has been placed, let us go to the database and check what is the quantity. Yes, the quantity is now coming. Okay. Now I can get the quantity for that particular query that I was writing there. So where was I? Let me close all these things. Okay, remove this check now because you have data inserted. Yes, and then close it now here. Okay, so right here OD dot, and you don't have in the list, but no worry, OD underscore quantity as quantity. Okay, so let us execute this first. Look, so the items are appearing along with the quantity. Okay, so what do you have to specify? You have to just pass a parameter here at the rate order id, and the order id is in big integer. So right here big int, and pass it here order id. So at the rate order id, fine. So let's execute this. So what will happen? Okay, again I have done the mistake. I have to select just this procedure and then execute. Now it's fine. Okay, so now order details and get orders. First thing that you have to do here in the database, in the software, is to write the method for orders. So where should you write that? In the retrieval window. First of all, come inside and public static void get pending orders, and then specify try catch in it. Okay, then you have to write SQL command cmd equal to new SQL command, and here you have to specify your procedure, then main class comma connection dot connection, and then specify this get orders. Okay, and paste it here. After that, cmd dot command type equal to command type dot stored procedure, and then do we have the parameters? Yes, we have the parameters. So no, we don't have any parameters. So SQL data adapter da equal to new SQL data adapter, and pass your cmd inside it that it will be execute. Then data table dt equal to new data table, and then da dot fill, what you have to fill inside dt, that is the data of da, and then you have to pass grid view data grid view. Okay, and give it a name gv. So I will pass this gv data source from here equals to dt, simple. Okay, and then write here exception ex and main class dot show message, and write the message that is ex dot message comma error. That's it. Save it, remove this throw, you don't need it, save it. So that's my method get pending orders. Okay, now let me write another method, copy it and paste it. Get pending order details, and here you have to specify the order ID that is in integer 64, order ID, and what else you need to pass here? The list box in which you will display the orders, list box. Okay, now what you have to do, you have to change the parameter stored procedure, sorry, and add it, and then you have to specify, remove this code, you don't need it, and instead of this you have to pass cmd dot parameters dot add with value, and then double quotes comma, and how many parameters you have to pass here? Only order id. So copy it and come here and paste it. Where is your order id? You will pick up from your function on runtime, and then main class dot connection dot open. Okay, you have to do this also, and one more thing you have to you can do that. Let me write here SQL data adapter da again equal to new SQL data adapter, and pass your query that is cmd, and then what you have to specify data table dt equal to new data table and da dot fill dt, and then your list box dot data source, you are binding your list box with the data source, that is dt. Okay, so that's what how you can specify. And then what you can do, you can okay, but there's a problem here. Inside list box you have the item on the front end, but where you can display the quantity, that's a problem. So list box is not as appropriate. Instead we can use a grid view here also. Okay, so we can use for list box, but it will become complex. So let me remove this list box and write here data grid view, data grid view, and write here gv, and instead of this write here gv. Okay, so the details will be displayed inside this. So save it, and now let's come to this screen and let's pick up the grid view from the orders window. So copy it and paste it here. That's my one grid view, and here you only need some columns that are remove everything. Okay, I don't need anything here. Instead I need here the order ID gv, order ID, it should not be, it should be visible, yes, and the heading should be proper, order ID, it should be read only, add. And then what you have to specify here, the status. Okay, so the status gv and status, it should be visible also, add, close, that's it. So this is my grid view with these things. Okay, now the hash column should be displayed cells, so that you can specify here. Now what you need, when you click on this grid view, the item details should display on the left hand side. Okay, or you can use this grid view on the left hand side and place the details grid view on the right hand side. So it's up to you, whatever the choice it's yours. Okay, remove this one, remove this one, you don't need this. Okay, now undock it and place it on the left hand side inside this and bring it here and make it doc fill. Okay, now the background color should be the same as of the left panel. So what was the color? That was steel blue. Okay, it's fine, so it's a steel blue. Now the grid color should be default cell style. Let's go to default cell styles and look, the preview in normal is white because your for color is white. So make the background color from window to steel blue web and steel blue. Now it's fine, and the selection of that should be, let's say, fire brick. Okay, so select that. Now it's fine, so the data will be displayed in such a manner. All the orders are appearing here, and when you click at any order, the details should display here. Okay, so let me copy once more this particular details. No, I don't need details, I only select, copy this and paste it here inside this details. Now what I need to display here, remove all the things, and instead of this you have to add the product gv, and the details heading is item, it is read only, and then quant quantity gv, and it should be quantity quantity. Okay, add, close. So these are the two things that I am retrieving, yes, item and its quantity. Okay, so I have added in this grid view, so I have taken two grid views. One more thing that you must mention here, that is the displayed cells of the serial number. Now it's fine, but look, this is going some on above and this is coming below. So you can make it on level. How? By placing a panel in this left panel and make it dock top. Okay, now it's set, and now make it dock fill and bring it to front. Now it's equivalent. Okay, it's in equal length. So fine. Now what we have to specify, we have to specify the functions that we have created. First of all, onload retrieval dot, what do you need? Get orders. What is the name of that? Get pending orders details. Okay, get pending orders, and it is asking you the grid view. So what is the name of the grid view? Let's see. Its name is data grid view 1 and its name is data grid view 2, hopefully. So that's my data grid view 1. So when the page is loaded, the pending orders will appear here. Okay, and then what you have to do, you have to go to on its click. So properties, events, and cell click. So right here, if e dot row index not equal to minus 1 and e dot column index not equal to minus 1, that means if no false clicks are there, okay, then data grid view raw row equals to data grid view 1 dot rows and select your current row dot from e dot row index, and then you have to take the order ID. So for that purpose, I am creating an integer 64 variable. That's my order ID. So order ID, and then right here order ID equals to convert dot to integer 64, and then raw dot cells of order ID GV dot values dot to string. Okay, then you have to use this order ID where to retrieve the order details. So retrieval dot get pending order details, and here you are being asked to provide your order ID. So that's my order ID that I have just taken, and then the grid view, that is my data grid view 2. So the details will be loaded inside that data grid view 2. Now one thing that you have to specify is the column names, so that the data will be binded. So go to your retrieval, because you are calling data, so data grid view column, and then you have to specify the order ID GV and data grid view column the status. Okay, status GV, so the binding will take place. How can you bind that? Here order ID GV dot data property name equal to DT dot columns of dot to string. So what is the name of my column? Let me see from the database. That's my order ID. So copy it and paste it here. And for status, you have a status GV. So pick up this status heading and paste it here. All right, and then save it. Likewise, you have to do this also in your order details. So after filling the data in data table, you have to specify the column names here. So data grid view column, and what will be the name of my column? That is the pro GV, that means the product GV, and then you need the quantity GV. So data grid view column QUAN GV. Okay, so these are my two columns, pro GV and then the quantity GV that you have to specify here, quantity GV. Okay, now instead of these two, you have to specify the headings of here. So item and quantity. So copy it and paste it here, and here you have to specify item. That's it. So you have binded the database columns with your data grid view columns. Now let's open this window. So from where you have to open that window, you have to go to your home screen too first. That's my home screen, that's my order button, and double click here and come inside. So you have to open what? The chef order window. So chef order window COW equals to new chef order window, and then main class dot show window, and then bracket open, and then opening window is cow, and then this is the closing window, and then MDI dot active form. Save it and let's start. Okay, the error is there. Yes, because I have changed the parameters, so I have to pass the parameters. To get pending orders, the first thing I have to pass here is order ID GV. So that's the column name, and then the status GV. So that's my status column name. And here also you have to specify the pro GV or product GV, and then you have to specify the quantity GV. That's my quantity GV. Save it and now let's run it. Login. Okay, I don't have to log in from the admin. Instead, I have to log in from the kitchen. So login, orders. So look, one order is appearing here by default. Okay, when I click on this, the details are appeared here. So when the person in the kitchen will open the software, the pending order should come here. And then when the order, when the kitchen person completed that order, then what he will do? He will just come here and then press any button to update the status of the order that it is served. Okay, and then let's do this work also, and then also apply the serial numbers here. So come inside the window here on load. After this you have to write retrieval dot serial number. No, main class. We have main class dot SNO for serial numbers. So grid view is data grid view 1 comma, and that's my SNO GV column name. Copy it and paste it. Okay, but one thing more that you have to do, let me show you. Hamad, and then orders. So okay, that is not appearing by default. Okay, numbers are not appearing, but we'll check that, no problem. But one thing I must tell you, that this software is open already. Okay, so you have to apply something here, that when you come on this window, after every 1 minute the screen or the order should automatically come here. You don't have to go back and come again on this window. So what you can do for this? So guys, one more thing I must show you. Let me show you that Hamad orders, and when you press back, you are on your admin screen. That's a security failure, so you have to override your back button. So let's go to the sample two. No, yes, we'll go to the sample two button. Do we have a back button here? Yes, here. So I am making it public virtual. Okay, now I'm copying it because I have make it virtual because to do overriding. And let's come inside this window and paste this, and instead of virtual you write here override, because I don't want to use this setting now. I wanted to go to that home screen too when I click back button here. So copy and paste, save it. So that's what I have overridden the button. Now let's check. Okay, log out. Hamad, login, orders, back, orders. Now it's fine. Okay, one more thing that we have to specify is the timer here so that the orders will come automatically here. Okay, so let us do that. On the orders, chef orders window, you have to go to your toolbox and pick up a timer from the components dialog box or the tab, drag and drop it. A timer is here. A timer is not a physically appearance UI control, instead it will run on the back end. Okay, so when you load this window, you just write here timer1.start. Okay, timer1.start. The timer will start. What happen when the timer will start? Let me show you its event. Select your timer, go to its properties. Look, it has only one event, that is tick. It is like the tick of a clock. The second tick that is happening inside the clock. Every 1 second the tick is going on. Okay, so that's what the tick is. So double click here and come inside. Okay, so what you can do on tick, write a variable that is integer count equals to 0. When the window will load, the count is 0. Okay, on every tick, what you have to specify, count plus plus on every tick. So how longer your tick will be, let me show you. Select your timer, go to its properties and look, interval. The tick will be of 1000 milliseconds. That means every tick is of 1 second. Every tick of 1 second. Okay. So what will happen? Every 1 second, this count will be updated to 1. I hope it is clear to everyone. When this count is equals to 60, right now I'm giving here 20 seconds or just giving here 5 seconds because we are in recording mode. You can write here 60. Okay, so every 5 seconds what will happen, the order should be displayed here. So from which method we are displaying the orders? From this method. Okay, so can I write here copy and paste it? Simple. After every 5 seconds what will happen? The orders will be retrieved. The pending orders will be retrieved automatically after every 5 seconds. And when the order will be retrieved, what you can do? You can make the counter to 0 again. And then one thing that you have to specify here in this, you have to stop the timer also. From where you can stop the timer? You can go to your back button. Because when you are going away from this window, you have to stop the timer one. Timer1.stop. Simple. So when you press the back button or when you close this window, so go to its form closing event and here you have to stop if timer1.stop. So when you are closing the window, the timer will be automatically stopped. Okay, once you are coming in this window, the order will be displayed. Okay, so let's start and place another order. Login, I'm giving an order here. Okay, add, and let's say I'm ordered a biryani and order type is dine in, floor is 1, table is 2, because 1 will not select because it is already in there in process. So 2 and add to cart and save, order placed. Now let's log out and log in from Hamad. Login, orders. Okay, now for demonstration, look, after 5 seconds that the numbers are there appearing. That means let me show you once again. After 5 seconds this red bar will go up. That means my records are loaded once again. So that's what you are trying to do. All right, so now what we have to do, when we press this save button, do something here, then that order will be successfully placed. So one more thing that you have to do, you can use this timer, or instead of this timer you can write or click or create a button here, and when you click that button the orders will be refreshed. So that's a more better option. Also this timer is also an option. Just for demonstration I have done this. So right now I'm removing this timer, and you can use this timer work all, no problem. Close, remove this code, remove this code, and remove this also. And where was timer underscore tick? Because this is of no use now, so remove this also. Okay. Now you can use that same functionality here in this button. Here you can place a button so that the orders will be fetched out with the help of this button click. So let's take a button and place it here. Go to its properties, make it flat, and the borders should be 2, and then its back color should be fire brick. Okay, so yes, fire brick. Now it should be displayed load orders and docket. First give it a name, load button and doc fill. Okay, so when you click load orders, the orders will be loaded. Okay, so double click here, and instead of this you have to specify this code, copy it and paste it here. Simple as that. Okay, now start and check what is the result. So login, and then we have to log in from Hamad, and then orders. So by default these two orders are coming, and when you click here, so orders will also appear. Okay, other orders will also appear. Now these buttons are not come into use. So what you have to do, you have to come inside and look, these are locked by default. I can't do anything. So what you can do, you can go to your sample to designer, sample to designer. Let's go to sample to designer, and that's my save button. Make it public, or you can use protected also. So copy it, that's my edit button, paste it. That's my add button, paste it. That's my delete button, paste it. And that's my search text, paste it. That's it. So whatever you need to make okay, or you can use it also public. So now it's fine, and it's time to rebuild. Hopefully this will remove the lock from this. Okay, clean solution, rebuild solution. Okay, close it now because you have rebuild, and open chef order window. Okay, start it, close it. You have to reopen it again and again. Look, but still it is appearing in the locks. So what you have to specify, you can do this, you can do something like you can disable these controls. So how can you disable these controls? Right here, add button, look, it is appearing. Okay, add button dot visible equals to false. You don't need the add button, you don't need the edit button. So edit dot, okay, what is the name, edit button dot visible equals to false. And then what else you need, the delete button. So delete button dot visible, you can make them enable false also. Okay, so visible equals to false, and you don't need search. If you specify that also you can. Now let's check Hamad orders, look. Okay, so only save button is there. And which order status you wanted to update, you have to apply a checkbox here. Okay, so check that particular box, and then that order will be updated here. Okay, so come inside and right here, you can specify what can we do. We can specify a button here, or we can use this save button. Whatever you wish to do, you can. So the better option is first add a checkbox, or instead of checkbox you can specify a button. Okay, so done, button GV, and the header is action. Okay, and it is a button column, so it's visible, and then okay. So action button, it should be down, and then the text should be displayed here. Make it done and make it true, because you wanted to display that done on that button, and then click OK. Right, so now let's start and see what is the result. Login, sorry, Hamad, orders. Look, so when you click done, it should be removed from the list, or the other order details should be loaded. Okay, okay, so click here, the order details will be displayed, and then when you place, you completed that order, then you place this done. Okay, so for that purpose you have to go to its cell, click cell, click, and if e dot row index is equals to on which number my button is 0, 1, 2, 3. It's on third index, so is equal to 3, but it is not row, it is column. So e dot column index is equals to 3. So when the click is on that button, okay, so what you will do, dialog result, you will make a confirmation message. Are you sure you want to finish that order? Okay, so dialog result dr equals to message box dot show, and are you sure you want to, are you sure, just write are you sure. Okay, then what the message, that is question dot dot dot, and then the message box buttons dot yes no, and then message box icons dot information or question. So right here dot question, so a confirmation dialog box will be displayed, and then if dr is equals to dialog result dot yes, if you press yes, then what will happen, the status should be updated. Okay, so for that purpose you have to write a stored procedure, that is create procedure st underscore update order status as @ status, and then update order set order underscore status equals to @ whatever status I will pass, update table orders. Why it is showing me errors? Update orders. Okay, let me write it in a new query. Now it's fine. Create procedure, procedure name, then status. Yes, that's the problem. Tiny integer. And then update orders, set order status. Whatever the status I will pass, where order underscore ID is equals to @ order ID that I will pass on runtime. So @ order ID, and that is my big integer. So that's it. So update order status. So let's go to the update and write here a method for updation. So copy this. Oh no, not copy this. Copy this one, because that's a small method, and paste it here. And instead of this, you have to specify here update order status, and the order ID that you will pass, order ID, and what else you need to pass here, integer 16, the status of the order. So remove this stored procedure and add your stored procedure, that is this one, and paste it here. Okay, and then what you have to specify, these two things, the status and the order ID. So that's my status, and then my order ID, copy it and paste it here. So here you write status from the parameter, and here you write order ID from the parameter, and then connection open, connection close, and then right here order, then status updated. Okay, order status updated, that's it. And then you have to go and enable to update order status and remove all other messages. Okay, that's my exception message, unable to update order status, that's it. So update order status, where you have to use this method, you have to go in the code here. When you press yes, so you will write this update, where, what is the name, updation dot update order status, and what it is asking me, the order ID. So that's my order ID. When I click the grid, the order ID will be fetched. Okay, and then what you will do, the status, what should be the status when you are confirming here, so you are updating the status to 1, that means you are in served mode now. Okay, you are updating the status. So let's save it and check it, what is the result. Start. Okay, so login from Hamad, and orders, two orders are already there. Hamad will see these two things. Hamad then created the order, and then he will click done. Okay, okay, that's the problem. It is working on the third column. You have to specify one more. Okay, let's go to the index, and because we have serial number also, that's why it is it was on the other click. So Hamad and orders, and then when you click here, first load these details and then click here done. Still it is not coming. Okay, we have to verify the index, why it is not coming here. E.column index, let us go to the check order details, and that's my 0, 1, 2 and 3, it's on third. So I was right. Okay, we'll see that. First of all, we'll have to check the functionality. Okay, so log out Hamad, orders done. Okay, so are you sure you wanted to complete? No, it's the message box is coming on this click, it's not appearing here. We'll check that, no problem. Okay, first, are you sure you wanted to do this? When I press yes, the order will be updated, but I am not pressing yes. One thing I have to do more, that is the get pending orders and this code. Copy it, and after update, paste it again. Okay, so that you can get again the pending orders after updation. So let's start, and right here Hamad orders. Okay, so are you sure you wanted to do this? Yes, order updated. When you click, look, but here you will not show this, you'll only load the pending orders. Okay, served orders will not be displayed here. Instead, you will show this as only pending. So what you can do, you can go to your queries, get order details. Here you have to write where O dot, okay, cut it and paste it, where O dot order status is equals to 0, that means pending. Okay, so only pending orders will come. So no need to write these things then, because you are only getting the pending orders. So that's it, else nothing, and simple as that. Or if you wish to leave it remain as it is, no problem. Okay, alter it and execute it once again, because you have changed this thing. Okay, now it's fine. So let's start and login, sorry, Hamad. Orders. Look, only one order is appearing here. When I click done. So are you sure you want to complete this order? Yes. Order status completed. Now there is no pending orders. When I click again load orders, the remaining orders will be fetched out. I hope it is clear. So I have mentioned two ways to load the orders with respect to the timer and with respect to this button. Okay, whatever you wish to do, you can do that. I hope it is clear to everyone. So that's all for today. Please try this at your homes, and if you do not understand anything, please do write me. Thank you so much. Take care. Allah Hafiz.